Hey, what's up guys? My name is Elijah and I was supposed to be your arts expert this summer, but instead we'll be doing some fun projects from home. So to get started for today, we'll be making a bridge out of 100 popsicle sticks. But first to get started, I have a special guest.
Hey guys, it's me, your girl Sierra, and we're about to make an amazing bridge that looks just like this.
So let's get started. What supplies you'll need. You're gonna need obviously your 100 popsicle sticks. That's what's included in your package.
All these in your box.
The glue that came sort of in this type of packaging or any type of glue that you get. That's what I'll be using. And then you can at the end have some paint if you want to paint your bridge.
It's optional. I think we're gonna do some painting though. I think you should snazz it up and make it all about you.
And then have some scissors nearby just in case you need to cut and edit some of your bridge mistakes. All right, so.
Let's start by not making your area so messy. We're gonna keep them in the bag until we need them.
A good way we found to start was to actually work on the sides of the bridge first. But again, it's up to you guys. Do it how you want. Just use the 100 sticks and make a bridge. That's the whole point. Awesome. So, just pouring the glue in. Our first step is going to work on the bottom part of the bridge first. So we're going to line up these four popsicle sticks and kind of overlap them at each end. And we're kind of doing four to start with, but you can do three, you can change it up if you like. And then you're just going to apply the glue onto the ends of wherever you're connecting it. So it's just not sticky everywhere, you know?
Gotta get your hands dirty. I know I hate when I get glue on my hands because it gets sticky and it sticks to everything. So just to keep it a little bit sanitary and from you getting aggravated, because I know I get mad at glue constantly working with arts and crafts. So like you said, just apply the glue to one end of the stick. You don't want to make it too far up because you're only going to stick the sticks together about this far apart. See? So you don't want too much glue. Hold on, can you see that? Oh, the light. Oof, right there, you see? That much, stick the stick on. Just like this. Right? Now, of course, you're gonna wanna hold the sticks together a little bit just so that they can get a nice, good hold on each other. But you wanna make them as straight as possible. Like that. So you'll have two sticks stuck together with some glue on the ends.
And then do the other.
Without doing it like that.
Keep it down on the table, clearly.
Just hold it between your fingers and it'll be easier to grab. Make sure you really lather the glue on there. You don't want to put too little, you don't want to put too much. Too much will make them slide, too little they won't stick. So just enough. If you don't get it on your first time, like this one over here, we will work on it. Ta-da! You might want to give them a second, give them a blow or two. You want to make sure that when you stick them together though, that you stick them on the same side. So you see how they're both facing upwards and the sticks like that. You want to make sure that when you do, it's all symmetrical. So
that stick's on bottom.
It's on the bottom. So clearly, you gotta let the sticks dry a little bit before you wanna work with them.
But if you know a better way, please do it. Show us, let us
know. Send us a message, let us know how you did it. If you found a better way to make this work for you, we'd love to know. While you're waiting, you could always work on the other side. Elijah had a great idea. We're waiting for these sticks to dry. We're gonna start on the other side. You need two sides to a bridge. So, let's get it going.
So, while they're drying, let's dance. They're pretty much dried. We all wanna connect the two together. And I hope that all four of them sit together.
They should, as long as you guys give them time to dry and yes. Stick them together real well. This should work. It might be a little time consuming to just wait but the end result will be great. Put them together. Place them down on your table, your desk, whatever you're using to stick them together. You got a lot to be smiling
for. And then you let them dry. Come on, I get my grin on. I'm smiling because I always get my win on. I've been on so many different stages, graced the cover of 100 magazine pages. Made people smile.
I think we should just have a dance break every time we're waiting for them to dry. So we're gonna play a new song every break, and hopefully you guys can just. It's summertime.
If you're breathing, you achieving. We having fun this evening, believe it. I'm living my best life. I ain't going back to fuck with you. I'm living my best life. I ain't going back to fuck with you. I'm living my best life. I ain't going back to fuck with you. I'm living my best life. I ain't going back to fuck with you.
Alright, so our next step is gonna be to start building the top sides of the bridge. So you're gonna take three popsicle sticks and put them at each connecting points of this part. So one there, one here, and one there.
Snoop Dogg, look, I ain't trying to throw no shade, cause I can't sing them in my lane. As long as my rent getting paid, I can care less with a beer bank, huh? You in the club every night with no job. Eating good off your food stamp card.
And it should look like this. So. This brick, though, we'll make one at the end. Alright, so once you have this part ready and dried for the next part, you're going to start to connect your other parts of this side and that side by starting with these two tops. So you're gonna connect one right there and one right there to start off with. And it should start looking like a little box window.
As you can see, I'm sure this might happen to you guys too. This comes off a little bit on the edge. Have these scissors. If your stick happens to come off, that's fine. Just reapply some glue and stick it right back on. But a little box. But this has to dry. This is a big foundation for our bridge. So you really, really want to let this dry.
Next step after you have this complete is you're gonna make about two popsicles to connect each ends so that it's sort of diagonal like that. So you're sort of gonna measure out how two sticks can actually fit there. So test it out, see what looks best. And then you're gonna glue these two sticks together. Like this. And then glue it on to the bridge. So it's like this on one side, and then like this on the other.
Boom, and that's one side halfway prepared. We still got to build the other side of this side of the bridge.
Your next step would be to add in your support to your bridge. This is very important so that your bridge can actually hold something like cars. You're gonna take two of your sticks, and just like we did for the edges, so just like we did for these, you're gonna wanna glue them together, but find your perfect size for your type of bridge. And it needs to go correctly across so that it's perfectly just like a little line across it over the box. And then do it for there, and then do it for right here, and then you're gonna glue it on. Once you glue on your whole side piece, So far, it should start to look like a nice little side of the bridge. Awesome. So, the last step to baking the side of the bridge is to just add on a little more extra protection to the bottom and top. So you're just gonna add on some sticks to the bottom, right here, and to the top. Just do it however you'd like, where you think it needs the most support. It's really up to you and how you make your own bridge. But again, you're just gluing on some more support to the bottom and the top of the bridge. We have our two sides basically done. They basically will look like these. Again, they're gonna be weird shapes, weird sizes, as long as you do have your side pieces done. Your next step, obviously you can change depending on however you like to build your bridge or however creative you are, but a way that we thought of was to basically put down all the sticks that are towards the bottom of this, the bottom length of the whole bridge. And then you're gonna look to find this masking tape in your box. It should be there. And it's gonna help you tape the sides if you're doing it this way. This next part, as we said for the bottom piece, you're going to line up all those sticks together and then shapely turn them and make sure they're in a straight line. Use the end of a book cover or something, or a box, anything you can use to make sure it's all aligned together. So when you tape it, the ends together, they should look perfectly aligned. Then you'll take your masking tape, pull a long piece out, and be very careful and try to match it correctly and press it straight down on it. And this is gonna help you attach your end pieces to the bridge. Oh, you may mess up, but try to align them back as much as you can. Even if you have to do it piece by piece, it's okay. It's okay. Okay, you do that one side and then you do the other side. So, after you put on the two pieces of tape, your next step would be to flip it over and you're gonna make the backside support piece. This is to help keep the bridge straight at the bottom and strong. You're gonna place three popsicle sticks or whatever amount you need and put them on each side and make sure they're securely on, gluing the full bottom of that popsicle stick. If you need to cut the ends to make it connect to the whole bottom piece, and that's also okay. Got some hand dandy scissors in there. So yes, glue on those pieces, and then one more time, you're gonna add two more braces basically onto your bridge where the corners are for the ends of the three sticks you already put. You let this dry. As you can see, it shouldn't be bendy anymore. It should look like this on one side. So you see the tape on that one side, and then on the other side, it should be those nice, perfectly aligned popsicle sticks on the side supporting that base. So, now we have all three pieces of the bridge complete. We're going to actually form it together to complete the bridge now. I'm going to put glue down each of these tape lines, but do it one at a time for each side, just because it's probably gonna dry quick. So, we're gonna put glue on one side, and then you're gonna quickly attach your bridge to it. And then do it again to the other side, and then put something up against the side so they can have some support while drying. You can use the paint bottles inside of your box or anything else that's heavy that can hold it up.
Most important part about all this, guys, is that you're having fun. Food, get a snack, something to drink.
Yes, I have some snacks on the side here.
Got my iced tea. Also, don't be afraid to leave it to dry for a little while when it's drying, because there's a lot of drying in this process. So don't be afraid to let it sit for a little while, keep it out of the way of anything, cats, dogs, little kids that you got running around the house. Just make sure you have plenty of space so that it can dry, so that you can actually have a masterpiece of your own, because that is our ultimate goal. We want you to be able to keep this bridge and have it as a forever memory. As you can see, guys, one side is glued.
Then you're going to attach your side of the bridge. So drop it right on there. And then just leave the bottle right by it so it leans on it a bit.
If you want, take some of your extra glue, glob it on there extra good, and come in on the sides a little bit just to get it to stick to itself. It might be a little bit of difficult of a process to get going. You might have to move it around a little bit to make sure it's actually sticking.
Or if anything, also use your tape if you need to. If the glue's not working for you, use any alternatives you can.
You want to make sure it's as perfect as you want it to be.
Especially when drying, so that it can help mold.
Right.
So let it dry for about 10, 15 more minutes.
Oh no.
And then we're going to come back and add on our last support, which is connecting a few more popsicles onto the top. All right, guys. So, as you can see, after you let it glue and dry, it should start to form into your awesome little bridge.
So exciting!
That should have came out really nice.
It really did come out nice, guys. I'm super excited. I'm proud of you guys. If it doesn't look like this, like we said, it's okay. It's your bridge. However you want it to look is how you want it to look.
But we're not done yet.
Looks good, though. As it is right now, gotta say, now on for the top piece. This is our last and final piece to our beautiful bridge.
What we're gonna do is basically connecting one, two, and then three pieces on the top just to connect them, just to make sure they're safe and secure. Added on our extra three pieces, but it's still looking kind of shaky and kind of unstable, so you can keep on adding pieces. So I'm gonna add some more right here to connect these two and then these two, just to make it a bit stronger, because you don't want it to break, especially if you put something on it.
Look like, as you can see, it's a little lopsided, but that's okay, because not everything is perfect.
And we'll give you guys a little 360 view. So as you can see, the completed bridge has all areas covered with popsicle sticks. The bottom is done, everything is strong, and it should look like a nice little bridge that you've created. Don't forget to show us your designs. Send them to Camp Morty on Instagram. And we'll see you next week.